Go to the sample database, new query, go to tables, production.org.order. This is the table we will see in this scenario. Let's see the columns and data within the table production.workorder. You can see the work order ID and product ID, order quantity and other columns in this table. So you see this order received date. Let's go to the requirement. You can see three requirements here. The first one is find records for products with product ID 995. So let's go back to the table. If you see the product ID column, you have different product IDs, but we want to find product ID 995 and its work orders. So let's rewrite this query. Now we can see the work orders for only the product ID 995. Let's see the second requirement. Find record for products with product ID 995 that has more than 500 orders. So let's go to the table and see how many orders are there for the product ID 995. You can see for 995 there are different order quantities, but we want to find order quantities more than 500. Let's rewrite the query now. We will use the greater than operator for this requirement, 500. You can see the product ID 995 and order quantity more than 500. And go to the third requirement. For product ID 995 that has more than 500 orders, we also need to make sure it is received before May 3rd, 2013. You can see the orders were received at different dates. You have records for 2014 also, but we are interested to find records received only before May 3rd, 2013. So again, we are going to filter the records using another comparison operator. It's going to be the less than operator. So it's May 3rd. And we got May 3rd here. Execute this one. And you can see the product ID 995 and order quantity more than 500 received before 2013, May 3rd. So you can't find the 2014 records. So you filtered records using three comparison operators in this scenario. The first is the equal operator, the second is the greater than, and the third is the less than operator.